Who the hell are you?
Natasha Hartford eyed the tall, muscular, scowling man.
I was just...
She winced at the thin squeak of her voice. The man's frown deepened, and the large executive office was suddenly too small, the maroon walls too close. She gulped and tried again.
I have an appointment with Mr. Waverly.
She took in her accuser's short dark hair, piercing hazel eyes, and rugged good looks. He wasn't Jonas Waverly, that was for sure. The grainy photograph of Waverly in the Port Hardesty Times had shown an older man with graying hair, dark bushy eyebrows, and a distinctive hawk-like nose.
Are you a security guard?
His gaze settled on her hands, and his eyes narrowed. A rush of heat flared up her neck, and she bit back a groan, wishing she could hide the two broken pieces of the delicate wood carving of a lioness and her cub.
This was an accident. I bumped against the table and...
The lump stuck in her throat threatened to choke her.
Of course, I'll pay for the statue.
Although God knows how she'd do that. The carving likely cost more than she made in a year creating illustrations for greeting cards. If possible, his mouth tightened even more.
I'm really sorry.
Tears stung her eyes as she forced out the words. She'd ruined the chance of a lifetime. After seeing the damage she'd done to his priceless work of art, Jonas Waverly wouldn't hire her to take out the garbage, let alone choose her to illustrate his company's best-selling children's book series. She set the pieces of the broken statue on the table.
Have Mr. Waverly send me a bill for the damage.
Crossing the endless expanse of thick, cream-colored carpet to the door, she couldn't resist a last glance at the panorama visible through the wall of windows in the opulent office. Even with heavy gray skies and the steady drizzle of rain, the million-dollar view of downtown Port Hardesty showcased the best of the seaside city. Snow-covered mountains draped in mist towered over the small bay, where, in spite of the weather, sailing boats, their multicolored sails billowing, flew across the waves. Who are you? She jerked and turned from the view.
I thought I told you. I'm Natasha Hartford. I have an appointment with Mr. Waverly.
She grimaced.
Or, rather, I had an appointment.
Had? The ticking pulse in his strong, dark stubbled jaw raced. His broad shoulders almost spanned the width of the doorway behind him, and even through the well-tailored lines of his suit, the play of hard muscles was evident.
I doubt he'll want to meet me now. Not after that.
She pointed toward the damaged carving on the gleaming antique mahogany table. Let me get this straight. He stepped toward her. You're telling me you had an appointment this morning with Jonas Waverly? For a heartbeat, the unusual color of his eyes, more green than brown, distracted her. Long, dark eyelashes swept his rugged cheeks. In other circumstances, she would have found him attractive. But not now. Not when her dreams lay shattered like the broken statue.
Tell Mr. Waverly thank you, but there's no point in us meeting.
Bullshit, lady. His eyes narrowed to slits of distrust. She flinched at the steel in his deep voice. What was his problem? She said she'd pay for the statue.
I'm sorry. I didn't get your name, Mr.
Chase Brandon. His large, bristling body sucked the air out of the room. Detective Chase Brandon.
You're a policeman?
She stumbled back a step. He nodded and removed a slim black leather wallet from a pocket inside his dark gray suit coat. Flipping the wallet open with practiced ease, he held it before her. A gold shield was on one side of the wallet, and an official-looking photograph of him on the other. Her mouth dried.
You're a cop? But this was an accident. I told you I'd pay for the statue.